So today we're going to make a snowman out of horseshoes. Stay tuned and I'll show you how to get that done. All right, this one's going to be another Christmas craft out of the horseshoes. You know, like I said before in the video, I found a guy and I bought like, I don't know, 60 or so horseshoes, 50 cents each. Can't go wrong. And they clean up pretty well. But what you're going to need for this one is four horseshoes and one piece of rebar or electric fence. So one of these, and this is going to be only if you want to put arms on it. And what I did was I actually, since I bought them from a farrier, I got all different sizes. So I just looked for three that were different sizes. So like right here, you got one, two, three. And then this one's the base, so it doesn't really matter what size it is. So that'll make it stand up. And that's all you need. Okay, so this was going to be a really simple project. You just arrange them until they look pretty nice and straight. Doesn't really matter because it's a snowman and they're all wonky sometimes. So especially if you don't have a lot of snow, they kind of don't tend to be stacked symmetrical. So it's not really going to matter ever how you want to do it. And you may even want to offset it a little bit to give it that more realistic look. So, you know, but I just put them on here, weld them, and pretty much done. Oh. And I'm just going to tack mine, and I'm going to do the welding on the back mostly, just because, you know, it's going to be in the front. That looks pretty good. Basic snowman shape, and then what you need to do is you get you one more. Like I said earlier, you get one, two, three, and if they're a little bit different size, that's great for a snowman. And then you find you another one. It doesn't matter what size this one is for your base, and that's just so he'll stand up. Yeah, so that'll give me 3-inch arm, 3-inch arm, and then little 1-inch fingers, and I'll just stagger them like right here. So let me get those cut. That was good. Just in the future, you might want to grind that down or cut it at a little angle, since you're going to be mounting them like this, and that way it'll be a little easier. All I did was just added some extra weld, and it still looks all right. I mean, it is going to signify a tree branch, right? Place that old top hat on his head. It's kind of crappy on the hat, but I'll wire wheel it down some and it should, you know, make it look a little bit nicer. But remember, this is just a little snowman. So I'm going to spritz that black, these black, and the rest white. So let me get him painted and then I'll show you what the final product looks like. I'm just going to paint the arms first and that way I can tape them off with some masking tape and then just paint the rest white. It'll be easier to just wrap some tape around these arms and the hat than it would be to get the body taped off. And you don't have to paint it, of course. This is just, you know, for some of these crafts I paint, I like it with the metal color, with the kind of the abstractness of it, but some people like it painted, so. There's the finished snowman, even with his scarf. You could add some eyes by welding some nuts in the top portion, or I've seen some where they put a rod kind of up the middle and they even put buttons and eyes and a nose and all that on there. But I just like this horseshoe look. I think a lot of the crafts that I'm making are gonna have this kind of, not detailed, right? Kind of the abstract snowman and all that. You don't need all that other stuff. You clearly can see that it's a snowman. So anyway, like I always say, just get out there, do something, you know? Try something new, take up a hobby, a craft, anything that you want to do. Try to get your kids involved young so that they will, just learning the basic tools and things like that is a great advantage in life. As always, we thank you for watching. Check back on Wednesday nights and Saturday mornings, and we'll catch you in the next video.